Hi children, welcome you all to my class. I hope everyone are fine. Today we are going to study 6th standard second language English prose Nirja Banot. Brave in life, brave in death. This lesson is in two parts. We are doing first part today. Okay. I hope children you are all ready for the class. Yes. Children, I hope you are all ready with your book, textbook and pen. Yes, very good. Children, we are going to learn about these topics. Those are introduction, glossary, prose, that is Nirja Banot, story time, exercises and assignments. Which is the first topic now? Good, it is introduction. We will see what we are going to do now. You have learnt Children of Courage lesson in class 5th. Are you? Yes. You have already learnt it. Can you tell some situations? That is a lesson about the children's courage who all got bravery awards. Can you tell some situations? Can you think of some situations which you had learnt? Okay. I hope you are thought about some situations. Let me see now. I'll give you two sentences. You should read that sentences and later I'll show you some pictures. You should match with the pictures. Okay. So Priyanshu Joshi, 10 years old from Uttarakhand, and Harish Chandra, 14 years old, Scott boy. So I'll show you two pictures. You should identify which pictures related to this sentences. Okay. Let us see the first picture. Here you can see a boy fighting with a leopard. Okay. So, can you tell me which boy among these two boys, which boy fought against the leopard and saved his sister? I gave you the clue. Which boy? Is it Priyanshu Joshi or Harish Chandra? Very good. It is Priyanshu Joshi. Okay. See that picture. See which boy saved? It is left out as Harish Chandra. You remember that situation? When there was on October 2nd, where our first Prime Minister, they had a gathering on Gandhi Jayanti, and there was a short circuit of fire and the fire caught to the tent, and a Scott boy saved the children by cutting a tent with his knife. So that was done by Harish Chandra, 14 years old. Okay. I think you know many other situations also. Good. Today, we are going to see the next topic is glossary. What is the next topic? Glossary. There are some new words. Glossary or come across this word. You have already padana kelidira alla makla. So, glossary means new words. So, we will see some new words in the lesson what we are going to do next. Okay. Let us see the first word. Attendant. See this word? Attendant. Attendant. A person employed to provide a service to the public. A person who is employed. A person who is employed to provide a service to a public. See, for example, in the flight or plane, a person, see, the person is helping the public to go and sit there. So, the person who helps the public or the other person who rents the service, yaro prayanikarige athava ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸಂಚಾರ ಮಾಡೋರಿಗೆ ಸಹಾಯ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೋ ಅವರನ್ನು ನಾವು ಅಟೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಾ ಮಕ್ಕಳ? ಸೊ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ಒನ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ವರ್ಡ್. ನೀರ್ಜಾ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಫ್ಲೈಟ್ ಅಟೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಮ್ ಏರ್ಲೈನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ನೀರ್ಜಾ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಫ್ಲೈಟ್ ಅಟೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಮ್ ಏರ್ಲೈನ್ಸ್. ನೀರ್ಜಾ ಅನ್ನೋ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಫ್ಲೈಟ್ ಪ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಮ್ ಅನ್ನೋ ಫ್ಲೈಟ್ಗೆ ಅವರು ಅಟೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರು. ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಲ್ಲ? Shall we move for the next word? On board. On board andre en makla nodi. On board means on a plane. Okay. You have seen people sitting in a plane. So they are on board or ready aagi kuntidare. So nodi iga ella flight alli they are on board. So the passengers are on board. The passengers are already in the flight. They are on board anta karitivi. Recipient. What you mean by recipient? A person who awarded something. a person who is awarded something. ಯಾರಿಗಾದರೂ ನಾವು ಏನಾದರೂ ಪ್ರಶಸ್ತಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟರೆ, ಏನಾದರೂ ಪ್ರಶಸ್ತಿ ಸಿಕ್ಕರೆ ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ನಾವು ರೆಸಿಪಿಯೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಪ್ರಶಸ್ತಿ ತಗೊಂಡಿರೋದನ್ನ ರೆಸಿಪಿಯೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ನೋಡಿ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್, ನೀರ್ಜಾ ಈಸ್ ಒನ್ ಅಮೌಂಗ್ ದ ಯಂಗೆಸ್ಟ್ ರೆಸಿಪಿಯೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ. ಇದು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಪಾಠದಲ್ಲಿದೆ, ಓಕೆ. ಸೊ ನೀರ್ಜಾ ಈಸ್ ಒನ್ ಅಮೌಂಗ್ ದ ಯಂಗೆಸ್ಟ್ ರೆಸಿಪಿಯೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ. ಹೈಜಾಕ್, ಹೈಜಾಕ್, ಹೈಜಾಕ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಏನು ಮಕ್ಕಳೇ? ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ ನೀವು, ನೋಡಿ ಓದ್ಬೋದು, ವಿಮಾನ ಅಪಹರಣ. ಹೈಜಾಕ್ ಆಯಿತು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದೀರಾ ನೀವು ಅಲ್ವಾ? ಸೊ ಹೈಜಾಕ್ ಅಂದರೆ ವಿಮಾನ ಅಪಹರಣ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಅರ್ಥ. ಸೊ ಯಾರಾದರೂ ಟೆರರಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಉಗ್ರಗಾಮಿಗಳಾಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಫ್ಲೈಟನ್ನು ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೋ ಆಗ ಅದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಹೈಜಾಕ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. PA-73 ಫ್ಲೈಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಹೈಜಾಕ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಟೆರರಿಸ್ಟ್. ದಿಸ್ ಫ್ಲೈಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಹೈಜಾಕ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಟೆರರಿಸ್ಟ್. ಉಗ್ರಗಾಮಿಗಳು ಅದನ್ನು ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಅರ್ಥ. ಅಲುಮ್ನ, ದೋಸಾ ಪದನ ಕೇಳೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ನೀವು. ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್. ಅಲುಮ್ನ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಅ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್. ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ ಪ್ರೈಮ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್, ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ ಚೀಫ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಅಂತೆಲ್ಲ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಏನು ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ ಅಂದರೆ? ನಾವು ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೈಮ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್, ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಚೀಫ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಅಂತಲೂ ಹೇಳ್ತೀರಿ ಕೆಲವೊಂದ್ಸಲ. ಸೊ ಏನಾಗಂದರೆ, ಹಳೆಯ ಹಿಂದೆ ಇದ್ದಂತಹ, ಈಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅವರು, ಹಿಂದೆ ಇದ್ದಂತಹ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ. ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಹಳೆಯ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಅಲುಮ್ನ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಅ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್, ಹಳೆಯ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಲುಮ್ನ. ಸೊ ಶಿ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್, ಶಿ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಟೀಚರ್. ಸೊ ಟೀಚರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಟುಗೆದರ್. ಸೊ ಶಿ ಈಸ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಟೀಚರ್. ಶಿ ಈಸ್ ಅಲುಮ್ನ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಟೀಚರ್. ಪ್ರಿಯಾ ವಾಸ್ ಆನ್ ಅಲುಮ್ನ ಆಫ್ ಸೇಕ್ರೆಡ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಸೀನಿಯರ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ರಿ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್. ಶಿ ಸ್ಟಡೀಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್. ನೌ ಶಿ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಂಗ್, ಶಿ ವಾಸ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಲ್ಲ ಮಕ್ಕಳ. ಸಿವಿಲಿಯನ್, ಸಿವಿಲಿಯನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಆರ್ಮ್ಡ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸಸ್. ಸೊ ಅ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಆರ್ಮ್ಡ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸಸ್. ಆರ್ಮ್ಡ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಏನು? ಸೈನ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ಇರೋರನ್ನ ನಾವು ಸಿವಿಲಿಯನ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಸೈನ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅವರು, ಬೇರೆ ಪರ್ಸನ್, ನಮ್ಮಂಥವ್ರು, ನಾವು ಸೈನ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸಿವಿಲಿಯನ್. ನೋಡಿ ಇಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸೈನಿಕರಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಇವರೊಬ್ಬರು ಈಸ್ ಅ ಸಿವಿಲಿಯನ್, ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅಸ್ ಸಿವಿಲಿಯನ್. ಸೊ ಅ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಆರ್ಮ್ಡ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅಸ್ ಸಿವಿಲಿಯನ್. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಲ್ಲ. ಪರ್ಸರ್, ಪರ್ಸರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಫೀಸರ್ ಆನ್ ಅ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಹೂ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಕೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಯಾಸೆಂಜರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಆಫೀಸರ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಹೂ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಕೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಯಾಸೆಂಜರ್ಸ್. ಇವರು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ನಾವು ನೋಡಿದ್ವಿ ಅಟೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಚಿತ್ರ ಬಂತಲ್ವಾ, ಅವರೂ ಪ್ಯಾಸೆಂಜರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಸಹಾಯ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಇವರು ಅವ್ರಿಗಿಂತ ದೊಡ್ಡ, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಮೇಲಧಿಕಾರಿಗಳು. ಈಸ್ ಆ್ಯನ್ ಆಫೀಸರ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆ್ಯನ್ ಆಫೀಸರ್ ಆನ್ ಅ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಹೂ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಕೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಯಾಸೆಂಜರ್. ನೀರ್ಜಾ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಸೀನಿಯರ್ ಫ್ಲೈಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಆಫ್ PA-73 ಫ್ಲೈಟ್. ಸೊ ನೀರ್ಜಾ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಸೀನಿಯರ್ ಫ್ಲೈಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್, ಶಿ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಆಫ್ PA-73 ಫ್ಲೈಟ್. ಎನ್ ರೂಟ್, ಎನ್ ರೂಟ್, ಎನ್ ರೂಟ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಆನ್ ದ ವೇ, ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ದಾರಿಯಲ್ಲಿ, ಅಂದರೆ ದಾರಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಅದನ್ನು ದಾಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗಿರ್ತೀವಿ. ಆನ್ ದ ವೇ, ಆನ್ ದ ವೇ ಟು ಆರ್ ಡೆಸ್ಟಿನೇಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಅ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್. ಅ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಅ ಮೌಂಟನ್, ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕ್ಲೈಂಬ್ ಅ ಮೌಂಟನ್. ಈಸ್ ಡೆಸ್ಟಿನೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಬಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ವೇ ಟು ಇಸ್ ಡೆಸ್ಟಿನೇಷನ್. The man is enrouted towards the mountain peak. He is enrouted towards the mountain peak. He is on the way to his mountain peak. Artha aita makle. Cockpit. Cockpit is a compartment for the pilot. In the flight you are seeing the pilots who runs the flight, right? So pilots where they sit, that cabin is called as cockpit. So you can see the instruments kept there, how to handle the flight. So this place is called as cockpit. We'll see the sentence. The pilot sit in the cockpit. Who will sit? Will the passenger sit in this cockpit? No, the pilots will sit in the cockpit. Crew, all the people working on a plane. ವಿಮಾನದಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾರ್ಯನಿರ್ವಹಿಸುವಂತ ಎಲ್ಲ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗಳಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಕ್ರೂ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. Can find the people who are working in the flight or plane. We'll see the sentence. Nija was one of the members of the crew. Neeja was one among them. She was also a crew like them. Neeja was one of the members of the crew. What is this? Tarmac. Tarmac means runway. It is called as runway. Runway. Runway means the going path of a flight, where it will move while taking up the flight. The path where it moves, it's called as runway. See, you can see the place here. So these are the tarmac of the flight. See, the flight is moving here. Can you see the flight moving on the tarmac? The two flights are on the tarmac. Flee. What do you mean by flee? Flee means run away. So when you go out of, or when you are going out of some situation or some incident, for example, if dog is coming, so you are running. So when you are running, it is called you are fleeing. You are fleeing from the dog. You are fleeing from the dog. Flee means run away. So the sentence for this is, we should not flee from responsibility. We should not flee from responsibility. Whatever is our responsibility, we should do the responsibility. We should not run away from our responsibility. Now, nama jawabdarigalinda odogabardu. Iga ond nai bartha ide andre navu odogtivi namna kaapadkolakke. So adanna navu flee anta karitivi English alli. So navu enadru kashta bandaga apagatha bandaga odabodu, adre namma ondu jawabdarinda navu odogabardu. Take charge. Take charge. Assume control. So what do you mean by take charge? We are not exactly charge of that, but we will assume that it is in our control. Iga, for example, iga school alli naavu nodabodu, in HM retire aadaga bere teacheru school in charge anna tagoltare, but avaru HM alla, but in charge aagi tagoltare. So ade reeti naavu nammadondu javabdari adu innobru barovargu nadaskondu hoguvantadanna naavu take charge anta heltivi. So that is called as assume it is in your control. Neeja, being the most senior cabin crew member on board, took charge. So when she was a senior cabin member, she took charge of the flight. Okay, why did she take? We'll see in the lesson. Children, I hope you understood the meaning better. So the next part, when we are doing the lesson, so you will understand the meaning better with the situation. Iga idana artha madkondidiralla makkale neevu. So iga next paatha madbekadre adra sannivesad prakara innu hechina taradalli nimge idu artha agutte. Okay na? So next we'll go to the prose. Neeja Banot. Children, can you see this picture? Can you say who is she? Gotta yarigadru yaar ivru anta heli nodidira ivurna? Film actress. She is an actress. No, okay. Next, any guess? You don't know who is she? Okay, I'll tell you who is she. We'll go to the lesson. Her name is Neeja Banot. What is her name? Neeja Banot. Very good. So, the lesson name is Neeja Banot. It's also entitled as Brave in Life, Brave in Death. She was brave in life and she was also brave in death. We'll see what is it. You like the story, right? Today we are going to know about Neeja Banot's story. Shall we start? Yes. Neeja Banot was born on 7th September 1963 in Chandigarh, India. She was the daughter of Rama Banot and Arish Banot, a Mumbai-based journalist. So Neeja Banot was born. Nodi yava guttidu mogu Neeja avaru yava guttidru 7th September 1963 in Chandigarh, India. Bharatada Chandigarhadalli janisidru. She was the daughter of Rama Banot and Harish Banot. She was the daughter of Rama Banot. Nodi avaru thai kaantidaralla illi avaru thai, then Harish Banot illidare avaru tande. So Harish Banot was based journalist. Journalist andre ಅವರನ್ನ ಪತ್ರಿಕೋದ್ಯಮಿ, ಅವರು ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಖ್ಯಾತ ಪತ್ರಿಕೋದ್ಯಮಿ ಆಗಿದ್ದರು. ಮುಂಬೈಯ ವಾಸಿ ಆಗಿದ್ದರು. ಅವರು ಮುಂಬೈಯಲ್ಲಿ ವಾಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು. ಶಿ ವಾಸ್ ಆ್ಯನ್ ಅಲುಮ್ನಾ ಆಫ್ ಸೇಕ್ರೆಡ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಸೀನಿಯರ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡರಿ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಚಂಡೀಗರ್, ಬಾಂಬೆ ಸ್ಕಾಟಿಷ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೇಂಟ್ ಝೇವಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಮುಂಬೈ. So, she was an alumna of Sacred Heart School. Alumna, alumna anno padada artha naavu nodidire. Nodidiralla makla neevu. So, alumna andre enu? Aa shaleya ondu haleya vidyarthi. Avaru odid shale yavudu andre Sacred Heart Senior Secondary School. Nodi idu Sacred Heart Senior Secondary School. So, idu bandu Nirjaba nod. Then this is the St. Xavier's College in Mumbai. Idondu prakhyatavada shale agittu. So, she studied in these schools. One more school is Bombay Scottish School. Nirja Bano joined Pan Am Airlines in 1986. She was the senior flight purser on the ill-fated Pan Am Flight 73. This flight was hijacked by four heavily armed terrorists after it landed in Karachi at 5 a.m. from Mumbai. So, Nirja Barnott, after her studies, she joined airlines. The airline's name was Pan Am Airlines. That was in 1986. When she joined to the airlines, and she was also given a post called Senior Flight Purser. Senior Flight Purser, and that was in Pan Am Airlines. On the ill-fated Pan, why they are called ill-fated, I'll tell you later. Okay, then this flight was hijacked by four heavily armed terrorists. So, this flight was hijacked. Hijacked means I showed you the picture, the terrorist is attacking the flight, right? So, the terrorists are attacking the flight. You can see here, Nirja was given a post of senior flight purser, and this picture indicates she joined the Pan Am Airlines, and here she is given a post of senior flight purser, and here the picture is where the terrorists are getting into the flight. In Karachi, the terrorists attacked, hijacked this Pan Am Airlines. PA-73, it's nothing but PA means Pan Am. Pan Am 73 was en route to Frankfurt and onward to New York City. Nirja alerted the cockpit crew about the hijack. As the plane was on the tarmac, so what happened when Pan Am 73 was en route to Frankfurt? So, it was in Karachi. It came from Mumbai, it was in Karachi, from Karachi it was taken to Frankfurt, it was going to Frankfurt, it was en route to Frankfurt and onward to New York City, it was next going to New York City. That time Nirja alerted cockpit, Nirja got to know that the flight is hijacked by the terrorists. So, she informed this to the cockpit crew about the hijack as the plane was on the tarmac, when the flight was going on the tarmac, she informed it to the pilot. See, the flight was going on the tarmac, she informed to the pilot. Then what happened? Then the three members, cockpit crew and pilot, co-pilot and the flight engineer were able to flee from the aircraft. But what happened? He was a pilot, engineer pilot, co-pilot, everyone, they got scared. They were afraid of the terrorists and they flee from the aircraft. They ran away from the aircraft. They left the flight. They went out. They ran away from the plane. And Nirja was being the most senior cabin crew member on the board. She took charge of it. So, she took the charge of it and she tried to manage the flight even though there was no pilot, no co-pilot and no engineer. Even though there was no pilot, no co-pilot, no engineer, no one were there, but Nirja stood and she wanted to save the passenger. She didn't flee from the aircraft. Children, if you want to know what is the next, you should wait for the next class. For today, I'm going to stop this lesson here. We'll go to the exercise part. The next story, I'm going to continue in the next class. Did you enjoy with the story, children? Now, I'm going to give you a short story. Now, I went through the lesson, right? Now, I'll give you a story, short story of the whole lesson what we did now. Shall we do? You listen to the story? You're bored? No? Okay. Now, it is a story time. So, who born? on 7 September 1963 was born Neerja. Yes, Neerja born on 7 September 1963. Our parents were, who were her parents? Yes, Rama Banot and Harish Banot. So they were her parents. What happened then? The child grew and she joined to the school. She finished her studies. So then what happened? She joined to the airlines as a air hostess. She joined as a air hostess in Pan Am Airlines. Then what happened? She, when did she join the Pan Am Airlines? In 1986. Then the flight was hijacked by the terrorists. Crew members of the flight, they flee from the flight, but Neerja took the path and she controlled the flight and she took the charge and she protected the passengers. We'll see how she protected the passengers in the next class. Okay, children, let me check now how well you listen to the lesson and how well you have understood. So to check that, I'm going to ask you a few questions. Are you ready? The question, the first question, who were Neerja's parents? Very good. Everyone told me the answer. Good children. Rama Banot and Harish Banot are the parents of Neerja. You should write down this in your notebook. Okay, children, you are writing it. Okay, take down in your notebooks. Ella barkobeku makla, nim book alli barkondo nim teacher torsbeku idana barkobeku. Next question, when did she join Pan Am Airlines? When did Neerja join Pan Am? Very good. Neerja joined Pan Am Airlines in 1986. She joined Pan Am Airlines in 1986. Who escaped from the aircraft? Who went? Who flew away from the aircraft? Who escaped from the aircraft? Yes, pilot, co-pilot and the flight engineer escaped from the aircraft. Children, are you taking down the notes? Okay. Where did Neerja study? Where did Neerja study? There are three schools. Yes. Can you name them? Okay. Neerja studied in Sacred Heart Senior Secondary School, Chandigarh, Mumbai Scottish School and St. Xavier's College, Mumbai. You can mark down in your textbook also. It is there in your textbook. You can mark it. Okay. Children, we will go to the next part. It is tense forms. You have already learned about the tense. Present tense, past tense. Alva? Vartamana kala, bhavishyat kala, bhuta kala anta kannadadalli navu heltivi. So, you have already learned about it. Now, we will see some words. And you have also learned about this in the lesson, King's Minister. About the regular verb and irregular verb. Anta na odidiri. Neevu already kalthidira adralli. Irregular verb andre yava kriya padagalu poorthi badalavane ondi past tense aguttho adana irregular antivi. Regular andaga elli ed form seriruttho. Aa padakke elli ed serustivo adana naavu regular form anta karitivi. So let us see some present tense are given here. You should tell me the past tense. Let me check whether you know these words. Okay. Try. Okay. The first word, die. What is a past tense form of die? Yes. Some told me the answer. It is died. Good. Hijack. Very good. You added an ed and it is hijacked. Okay. Join. Join. Joined. Yes. Land, landed. Good. Children, you have done a good job. So, some have taken the help of the textbook and given me the answer. Good. Kelo textbook nodi nu helidira. Olledu. So, iga next words nodiga. Iga go ide. Idakke naavu ed form na add madala. So, instead of ed form, we have the other form. That is irregular verb. A word change agute. Go andaga past tense en balustivi makle. We go to school andaga. ನಿನ್ನೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಬಂದಿರೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀರಾ ಮಾಡಿರೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಎಸ್ ವೆಂಟ್ ಗೋ ವೆಂಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಟುಕ್ ಶೂಟ್ ಶಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ಓಕೆ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ past tense of these words. Okay. This table is there in your textbook. You should write down these answers in your textbook. ಬರ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀರಲ್ಲ ಮಕ್ಕಳೇ? ಓಕೆ, ಬೇಗ ಬರ್ಕೊಂಬಿಡಿ. ದೆನ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಟೇಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ಯೋರ್ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬುಕ್. ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಲೆಸನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರೈಟ್ ಡೌನ್ ಫೋರ್ ಮೋರ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಯೋರ್ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬುಕ್. ಇನ್ನು ಆ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಪದಗಳನ್ನ ನೀವು ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಆ ಟೇಬಲ್ನ ಪೂರ್ತಿ ಮಾಡಿ. ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ. The last topic for the day is assignment. We have come to the end of the class. Let us see what is a assignment. You should answer two questions. Children, idanna neevella barkoli. Idakke eradakke neevu uttara neeve baribekagutte. Prashne enide andre, why was the flight described as ill-fated? Yake naavu vimanavanna ಇಲ್ ಫೇಟೆಡ್, ಅದರಿಂದ ಏನೋ ಒಂದು ತೊಂದರೆ ಆಗಿತ್ತು, ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಯಾಕೆ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನು ನೀವು ಬರಿಬೇಕು. ನೇಮ್ ದ ಫ್ಲೈಟ್ ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಹೈಜ್ಯಾಕ್ಡ್. ವೆನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೇರ್ ಡಿಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್? ನಾನು ಈಗಾಗಲೇ ಪಾಠದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಈ ಫ್ಲೈಟನ್ನು ಹೈಜ್ಯಾಕ್ ಮಾಡಲಾಯಿತು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಮತ್ತು ಯಾವಾಗ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೆ. ಅದನ್ನು ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬುಕ್ಕಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಉತ್ತರ ಬರೀಬೇಕು. ಬರೀತಿರಲ್ಲ ಮಕ್ಕಳೇ? ಜಾಣ ಮಕ್ಕಳು. ಓಕೆ. You make sentences using the words from the box. An example has been given. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ, ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಪದಗಳನ್ನ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ. ಈ ಪದಗಳನ್ನು ಬಳಸಿ ನೀವು ವಾಕ್ಯ ರಚನೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಒಂದು ವಾಕ್ಯ ರಚನೆ ನಾನು ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ನಿಮಗೆ. ಸೊ ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ನೀವೇನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ವಾಕ್ಯ ರಚನೆ ಬೇರೆ ಪದಗಳನ್ನ ಬಳಸಿ ನೀವು ವಾಕ್ಯ ರಚನೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಕಡಿಮೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಮೇಕ್ 10 sentences. You should make 10 sentences. One example is here, I have visited Hyderabad. So you should also use some words, as many as more than 10 also you can try. Minimum you should make 10 sentences from these words. Okay, you should do this and show it to your teacher. Will you all do it? I hope you will do good. Okay. Thank you children. I hope you enjoyed the class. I'll meet you in the next class for the remaining story. Be ready. Okay.